Hey everybody, it's Tom from the Corona team, and the fact that you're watching another video from me means it's time for another Corona release. This is Corona 12 Update 1, and in this video I'll give you a very quick introduction to the new features and what they will let you do, using some sample and test scenes that we've been using during development to try things out and make sure they're working as expected. You'll get full details in our blog post, plus of course over the coming weeks we'll be releasing tutorials that will walk you through the details of every feature. But for now, let's dive on in. So head on over here to the Start Live Link button. This is in Max. We'll show you C4D in the tutorials later. With Vantage up and running, it's easy to adjust the lighting and see the results. We can also move objects. In this case, we have a poltergeist with a flying chair in the basketball court. We can adjust our camera to find the viewpoint we want. And we can edit materials. And there will be more to come from the connection to Vantage in future releases. For example, the ability to render animations through Vantage, animations that you set up inside your DCC. Unfortunately, that wasn't possible to fit into this release, but that means it's next. And of course, we'll continue to look at other ways of improving the connection between Corona and Vantage. Now, it doesn't matter what kind of project you're working on, there's one thing that's always true, which is you have to share drafts and finals with your clients, and they have to give you feedback. I'm sure most of us have come up with our own solutions to this: email, Dropbox, the client has to open up the copy of Paint and draw red rings around things in order to make comments on them. Those days are gone now. Cloud collaboration will give you a way of working with your clients, making everything streamlined and easy and accessible, even directly inside 3ds Max or Cinema 4D. So let's take a look at that. So here I am, I'm using C4D here, and let's upload this to Cloud Collaboration. Head on over to the Collab tab. Then use Prepare Image for Upload. Let's create a new project for this one. And then we'll upload. Now we have the option to open it in the browser. And from here, I or my client could add a comment to the image. So let's do that. And then, of course, we can have a discussion between my client and myself on making changes. And finally, we also have an option to manage the versioning. Once I've made some changes, I can upload a new version. I've set up a virtual tour, so let's take a look at that. I'll head into the project folder, and then you can see the virtual tour icon. When I click on this, I have the images that make up the tour, and I can just start the virtual tour. What's great about this is I can send this to my client, and then my client can also embed it on their website so that their customers can use it. So we have the panoramic image, and I have set up hotspots so that we can move from area to area. What we'll be able to do in the future is have the hotspots set up automatically. That's a functionality that was introduced in V-Ray 7, and we'll introduce that for Corona later on. But right now it's very easy to set these up manually, so it's still very functional, and you'll be able to set up your own virtual tours without having to use any third-party software or solutions for doing that. So that was quite a lot of information on the Live Link to Vantage and Cloud Collaboration, but there's lots else in this release, so let's take a look at that now. Caustics will render much faster. There's nothing to change, no new parameters or anything. Existing scenes will render faster too. We're not going to give a speed up in terms of overall render time, as it depends how dominant the caustics are in the scene. The best measure I can give you is to say that caustics will look visually about twice as good in the same amount of render time. And by as good. What I'm referring to is that there will be less noise, they should be brighter, and they should be clearer and more well-defined. As well as the speed-up, we're also adding a new Caustics parameter called Surface Multiplier. When set to above 1, it will amplify the brightness of the Caustics compared to the rest of the scene, and less than 1, it will make them darker. You do have to set this before rendering, so you can use IR to find the right levels. And then it gives you that ability to refine and control the brightness of the Caustics compared to everything else in the scene. So we just saw the faster Caustics, but we've actually introduced a whole new side to Caustics that very few render engines can offer, and that is the ability to see reflected and refracted Caustic rays as they pass through volumes. Here you can think of a disco ball reflecting light through the smoky atmosphere of a nightclub. You can think of beams of sunlight when you're under the ocean as they ripple and change based on the surface refracting the rays from the sun, and so on. You'll see various examples as I'm talking, and these should give you a very clear idea of what this new Caustics through volumes functionality is. It's enabled by an overall checkbox, and then you can enable it per volume. And you also have, just like you have a surface multiplier, you have a volume multiplier, so you can control the intensity of the volume effects to get exactly the result you want. We've added automatic exposure and automatic white balance. You can activate either or both of these and then bake them to the scene as a starting point, or you can leave either or both enabled during an animation so that they continually adapt to changing lighting in the scene. We've also changed the white balance algorithm to make it more pleasing and make it more like the white balance found in other applications. For speedy draft animations, we've added NVIDIA's AI Image Upscaler. This lets us render a frame to 1/4 of the pixels, in other words 4 times faster, and then upscale it to the final resolution. It will have flicker, which is why it's only suitable for draft animations. You can also use the feature during IR, and this may give you a speed up, depends how heavy the parsing is, and the larger the IR size, the more benefit you'll see from it. In Sketcher, we've added a few default distribution maps that you can choose from a drop-down list to apply to the results of your Sketcher. Now, you've been able to use custom maps for a while, but these defaults should give you some great starting points and speed up getting the results you want, particularly when it comes to the scattering of vegetation. For Cinema 4D specific improvements, we've improved the scene converter so that you can more easily convert your scenes to Corona. And we've also enabled the export to CXR format from Cinema 4D itself, rather than just from inside the VFB. This will let you save CXRs from batch rendering, animations, etc. Well, that turned out to be quite a long video. Thank you for bearing with me. There was a lot to show. As I say, you'll find full details exploring more of the parameters and options in the blog, and most especially in the upcoming tutorials that we're going to create. Just before I go, if you're curious about the name, why 12 update 1 rather than 13, it's simply because we knew we had a couple of things that would take a lot of development to get ready, namely the live link and moving to the new Chaos installer, and we didn't know how many other features we'd be able to include. Turns out that was quite a lot, but just to be safe, we decided to call it 12 update 1. We will see an update 2 sometime in the first quarter of next year, but the next major release, Corona 13, will be planned for somewhere in the middle of next year. Lots to look forward to in 2025. We have a lot planned, so it's going to be an exciting year. Meantime, however, of course, enjoy 12 update 1, and the best part of it for us will be seeing what you create using the new features and tools at your disposal. Thanks for watching, everybody.